Welcome to the Math 1 lesson summary video for the task Linear, Exponential, or Neither. This is a practice understanding task. The purpose of this task is to determine whether functions are linear or exponential from multiple representations. So if given a graph or a verbal description or a table, we want to be able to decide, are we looking at a linear, exponential, or something else? Which in this case we'll call neither. So to recap, first of all, some of the main ways we can tell that a function is linear is that it has a constant rate of change. That's the number one way. And you can tell that that would be a straight line on the graph, or there'd be a constant difference between terms in the table. Or in the verbal description, there would be some kind of description that indicates that it's a constant rate of change, such as Timmy works making $7 an hour. That's a constant rate of change because it's $7 every hour. On the other side, so you have graphs that look like, for linear, you have graphs that look like this straight line here or here. It doesn't matter whether it's going up or down. Exponential is going to have a constant ratio between terms, which we've called the common ratio from geometric sequences. It's going to have an exponential curve shape. So you'll notice we have an increasing exponential curve or a decreasing exponential curve. And it could look like either. But just because it's curved doesn't mean it's exponential. It has to look like one of these two things. So notice how they look, how they come close to the x-axis but don't cross it. And so we'll continue to reference back to that. So first up, we have a scenario of a tennis tournament. And the question is this linear, exponential, or neither? So if I was to suppose that it was linear, I'd say, okay, the difference here from 64 down to 32 is 32, but then it's only 16. So instantly I can tell it's not linear because it's not a constant difference. But is there something I can multiply by every time that's going to get me from one term to the next and the y values of this table? And the answer is yes, it's multiplying by 1/2 every time. So we know that this is exponential, the constant ratio is 1/2. So that's one reason I was able to tell that it's exponential. And then I could also graph a table. I could create a graph of this table to see if it's going to have that exponential kind of curve. So I've graphed these points in Desmos, and it's not immediately obvious that it is going to have that exponential kind of curve, but if we continue it out, it becomes a little bit more apparent that it will have that type of shape. And in the context, it wouldn't make sense to keep going, but I could write a rule that's really going to indicate the shape. So using our knowledge from the previous unit, so we're starting at 64, we're multiplying by 1/2 every time, and you're not asked to do this for this task, I'm just doing this to show a visual point. So it'd be raised to the x minus 1 power. And now you can really see that exponential curve shape that fits through all those points. So we had a constant ratio of 1/2, and the graph has exponential shape. Those are our two reasons. And let's look back at the exponential shapes again. So notice how those two curves look. So number 5, the question is, does that curve look like either of these two curves? And in terms of shape, it does, but in terms of the properties of having a y-intercept and not touching the x-axis, this is actually quite different. So even though it has a curve, it's neither. And so we could say, when it says y, we could say exponential functions don't have x-intercepts. That's one distinguishing factor. So notice how both of these exponential graphs up here, they never touch the x-axis. Therefore, they don't have x-intercepts. All right, and then going to number 8. So we have another scenario where we want to check from a table. So we can see it's decreasing by 23 down to 5. That's 18. Went down by 18. And down by 18 again. Down by 18 again, and down by 18 again. And that was for changes on this side of 2. So if I want to find the constant, we can see that it is a constant rate of change. If I want to find what that is as a unit rate, that would be negative 18. It went down for every 2. Negative 18 on the y, it went down for every 2. It went up on the x. So that's a constant rate of change of negative 9. And so the only other way we'd be able to tell that it's linear is by looking at the graph. And so I've already pulled that up here. So we can see that those points are going to be connected by a straight line. So it is a linear function. All right, and so that takes care of this video. You would have several other problems to do, but hopefully this gets you started and you're able to finish it. And then check in with your teacher tomorrow. If you need help specifically with the Ready, Set, Go homework problems, check out the Ready, Set, Go student support site in Canvas.